a neighborhood next to mine is a nonsense house abandoned between blocks of flats and a small park. The house has a little garden in front of the door and another larger behind the house with high centennial trees and palms. The property is fenced in by high walls, but it can be seen through some cracks. It must have been a splendid house in old times. Some years ago, I had an obsession with it. It started when I saw it for the first time. I saw the dwelling and approached to it. The first thing that came to me was the smell of a mixture of humidity, roses, and cinnamon. The closer I got to the walls, the more acute was the smell. I got very close to the gateway. I landed my hands on the gate and I looked through a gap. The surface where I was landing was lukewarm, even though the sunlight was caressing it for several hours that day. It was like touching the sand on the beach.
The sensation was pleasant. I felt a tingling in my hands and throughout the whole body. I looked inside slowly and carefully. I wanted to look into every single detail of the house. The windows, the hard roof, old stairs, the wooden main door, the bushes. My view was clouded. I closed my eyes. My mind was flooding of a pink golden mist. The broken melody of a piano was reaching me. It was inside of me. As I was listening to it, the melody became clearer. Chopin Nocturne, Opus 9, number 2, it was. Suddenly, images came to me little by little, more and more clearly, accompanying the music. Now I saw the house magnificent and white. The light blue windows, as well as the green door, were open, and the airy curtains were dancing with the gentle wind. On the porch, a loving old woman was rocking softly on an exquisite rocking chair. Her dress was antique. It could have been from the end of the 19th century. The garden was huge and full of colorful plants. Flowers, trees, and bushes were everywhere. The path from the entrance to the house had arcades of beautiful red and white roses. Three little children were playing in a green lawn circle. A young woman brought some cookies for them. My mouth was fulfilled with cinnamon flavor.
Abruptly, images became gray. The door and the windows closed all at once. And gradually, suddenly, everything became colorless and old. Tears were flowing down on my cheeks and burning them. I opened my eyes slowly. A nice breeze with a very strong smell of roses and cinnamon catalyzed my face.